So, is Jun for win streak in Overman battle? He's doing pretty good, and he's really excited that he's good at this video game. Amazing. Sagumi's worried though, considering they were sent here to buy some supplies. He's like, ah, relax. Everybody else is playing some stuff here, so we can relax for a bit. And he's hyped for his fifth match. And then that's it. He's just done immediately. This mysterious girl, and she's like, hey, yeah, you're decently skilled, but not enough like you can go around acting like your hot stuff. And Jun goes, yeah, that's right, but my friend would mop the floor with you if he was here. And she's like, yeah, bring him on. I'll give him what for. And then Gainer shows up. He's like, oh, Jun, paying over battle, huh? And Jun's like, hey, nice timing. Show us your mad skills, dude. Shut this cheeky girl up. Jun looks like he's trapped in the video game here, doesn't he? He's just there in the screen. He's like, hey. Look at him. He's just trapped in a video game. Especially the way that he doesn't have any legs. He's just in the screen. Yeah, and then he's like, play a game. And she's like, yeah. It's like, yeah, sure, do it, Gainer. And then Sarah's like, no, we didn't come here just to play around. And he's like, yeah, he'll get mad at us if you don't get back soon. And she's like, running away. Is that it? And then Sarah's like, what? We're in the middle of something far more important than gaming. Impossible. What could be more important than gaming, Sarah? And then the girl is just like, and what are you? What? He's like, the Gainer. What are you, the Gainer, huh? She's like, oh, I'm Sarah Kadama. I'm Gainer's what? Comrade. And Gainer's like, just that? Ugh. And she's like, oh, it took so long for us to finally meet, so at least let us take a souvenir picture at a nearby booth. It's like, what, picture? And it's like, yeah, it's not so often that the queen and king are in one place, right? He's like, queen, that means, she's like, yep, that's right, Gainer, it's me, the goddess herself. Yeah, you're like, you were meant to meet me at Cortez, but you didn't, so it's me, Cynthia Lane. Cynthia. And then Tsugumi's like, who? And then Jun's like, oh, they in the overbattle game, they're like, she's the queen, she's the champion, they're like, is an MLG pro rival, the pro gamings. But here, and I mentioned Katea, Sarah's like, wait, she was your mystery date? She's like, oh yeah, couldn't we have that today? And Gainer's like, yeah, yeah. And Sarah's like, Tsugumi, go ahead without us, because I will be accompanying Gainer to keep him out of trouble. And Jin's like, nah, that doesn't really make much sense. She's like, you got a problem? He's like, no, nothing. And then Cynthia's like, it'll be fine. I think it'll be more fun with Sarah around. Let's go, Gainer and Sarah. Wakatayo, Cynthia. And at the Agate Crystal. Agate Crystal. His angel saying that Asim's crew have sent word they're on the trail of the Black Southern Cross. And here's Kids Muntz, the head of the Siberian Rail. And he tells Angel to let them do whatever they want. He wants to make use of the man's obsession. And here's Timp. And he's impressed that Kids put together such a large offensive just to crush Zuth. He's like, yep, all part of the plan to get the Siberian Rails on her back. They might not be able to go after the Exodizers now that it's finished, but we can certainly make an example of those who enabled it. And so, Timp and former Chief... Yeah, so he's like, Timp and Chief of Operations, and then Timp's like, don't you mean former Chief of Operations? And Kashmir's like... So they've been sent to deal with the main fleet, and Kashmir really wants his old job back if he succeeds, and that's obviously fine with Kids Muntz. and Kashmir swears to grant him a crushing victory. But he does have to take it easy because he came in person for more reasons than just seeing this Zoot stuff. And they're like, oh, what's that? And he's like, he's not going to say just yet, but it'll begin Siberian Rail's domination of all of the continents of the world. And Cynthia returns, she's in a real good mood, and Kid starts to get ready to launch soon. And she promises to do her best. And then Kid orders the Agate Crystal to begin moving. It's time to lay judgment upon Zoot! Zoot. And so, back in the Iron Gear, Gaiden and Sarah got yelled at, obviously, for putting all the shopping on Jun and Sugumi, but Ran's pleased that Gaiden's a big enough man to skip out on work and drag his girl all over town. An OG or SD game? Like, an OG or a normal one? I think we've been getting an OG one. There's been, like, lots of rumblings. He raises a toast to the growing kid, and then Anna's like, Ran, you always seem to find a reason to chug a drink. And he's like, that's right, kid. Thanks for noticing. And Bunray's like, wow. And he's like, that kind of tranquility only comes from making it past 20. But the drinking is a little bit sad because, you know, Gain's not here to help. But there's Gauli and Adet to join him. And unfortunately, Holland, the old Gecko State fellas, he doesn't make good company though, he's too grumpy right now. And Anna knows exactly what he's talking about. She misses Chiru. Yep, and then they also miss Chiru as well. And but Mel figures that Tifa and Mimsy are feeling even lonelier with their men away. And she's just not really listening, but she's not thinking. And it's like, oh, look at that, I bet you're thinking about Jiru and her. And she's like, I got it. It's like, what would you, where are you jumping up out of this nowhere? And she's just realized something. She's been pondering why the 100 Demon Empire would be checking out the Innocent Dome. And it must be because they're trying to learn from their culture. And that sounds like dumb as hell. Burame's like, what? That's so fucking stupid. And then it doesn't seem right. And then Rand and Coruscant are like, why would they be after innocent culture in particular when there's so many others to pick from? Which one will power that was on Gunbuster in Z3 Part 2? Gunbuster, like, easy, it's nuts. So Elchi points out proudly that the innocent are the descendants of a much older civilization that was destroyed in the ancient cataclysm, and that their devotion to the lost past must have caught the demon's eye or something. Laban doesn't really take them to be that romantic, or like, they'd be much more approachable, right? But then Elchi gets in his face and he's like, that ain't my theory, huh? And then he starts going, oh, that's all, oh, I'm really sorry, please, your lady, can you step back from me just a little bit? And she's like, oh, sorry, I forgot that little quirk of yours. But if Elchi's theories is correct, that'd make the demons kind of like Anna's dad. Because, you know. Not because. And they're like, what, your dad's a demon too? He's like, no, you fool, he's not a demon. He just loves antiques. And then Mel's like, yeah, oh yeah, Duke Madai is a big collector of ancient relics, like painted statues and even overmen, right? And it's like, yep, even Gainer's Mech was one, and it dates all the way back to the Black History. And that's when the original Mia's first exodus and Zora's cataclysm happened 12,000 years ago. Anna remembers Lyubov telling her that there are a lot of mysteries surrounding what happened then 12,000 years ago, but, you know, seems like there was an overman back then that had some unimaginable power, and Mamado wondered if King Gainer was one of those. And Elchi is like, ah, oh, yeah, distant age, shrouded in mystery and shadow. Whew. And then Ran's like, oh, no, I don't think they got anything good in them shadows. And then Fat Man. What is it, Fat Man? What's wrong, Fat Man? What? Something's falling from space. It's like, something's falling from the sky. Wah! It's heading right for us. Here it comes. I just love how he's just lassie. He fetches up the second game by PlayStation 4. No. You can't even get it on the PS3 anymore. They took it off the store for some reason. But this is Mission 34 of the Ship's Route, the Wrathful Railroad King. Ikari no. Oh, no. Big egg. And so the object is the Agate Crystal, and demonstrating its Agate Gravity attack, as it says here, and we just barely managed to avoid it. Odette recognizes this is the Siberian Rail's mobile fortress, and it's proof that the Railroad King is here in person. So, Kids Munt! Oh, she tells everyone to pull back, but Kids isn't going to let us avoid our punishment. And he deploys every fucker in the world. And so Tip's leading the charge, and he tells us to prepare a medium maker. Now we've pissed off the boss man. And Kashmir is like, yes, well said. And he's going to promise divine retribution for our hand in Japan's exodus. And so, Kejinan, Inge, and Jaboli, they're here too, and Rand calls them the Three Stooges. And they're like, oh yeah, we got overwhelming numbers, we're finally gonna win! And you got less than half what you had from before! Ha ha! Yep, numbers put victory on our side. And that's why Matthew hates bumping heads with rich folk, but it's too late to complain. Holland and Elchi tell everyone to launch. And so, Kitsis King Gainer coming out and calls for the Mystery Overman, the Dominator. Yes, he calls for the Dominator. And he's like, oh, that's the Overman we fought before. And Sarah's worried about how what we're supposed to do now. And Cynthia, who's still here for some reason, is eager to play with Gainer. Gawley thinks we might have to prepare ourselves for the worst. And Royby tells him to quit jinxing us. And then Duke says that this situation demands that kind of resolve. So Jumil sends the Glomar off to pick up Garrett and friends while he and the others hold the fort. Captain protests that we can't win without the Glomar's power. And Talo's like, just get going now, Captain. So Shia agrees to do so. So Kejinen, like, he keeps stressing form. He's like, what are we going to do now? Former Chief of Operations. He's like, first thing you're going to do is drop that former. Probably a good start. And then Tip figures that he's like, yeah, we can let him go. We'll focus on hunting the prey right in front of us. And she's like, you're in for a rude awakening if you think you can kill us easily. We're not wanted men for nothing. This sort of thing ain't scaring us. We'll see how far along that confidence holds. The legacy of the Black History. The power of the devil will awaken shortly. Power of the devil? Far away, folks. Make sure you put on a good show for the boss. And so, within five turns, shoot down everything, and then the Dominator. So, no surprises, you just gotta fight these guys. That's nice. But they're sort of spread out all over the place, and we gotta get over here, and there's land ships, and Tip's in his land ship, and he's strong as fuck. And this man is still strong as balls. This is Tip, right? Yeah, it's Tip. So, this is why we wanted the good move. So, we have Aquarian. Brush over there, he's got the double attack, and Rand has Valor on Mel, so they should be able to blow him up. And Kashmir hits for Gainer constantly, so that's not too bad. right? Like, the routes are completely different for the two characters, right? Compared to... Like, there is, like, a couple of stretches where it's equal, but... It's like, nah, just a bunch of people just fuck off and go do some shit. So... Time to head for the Timp Man. Itadaki! Leon! Like, I'm expecting the April stream will be announcing the OG game as their big anniversary thing, because April is like, that's the anniversary. So I'm expecting them to be like, oh yeah, here's going to be the anniversary game, we're going to do an OG, it's going to do all of Alpha 3, and we're going to do, and also there's going to be a mainline one, like, not long after. And I'd probably like expect an announcement of like a new gacha game to replace Cross Omega. Yeah, that's certainly a wild one to hope for. Is he supposed to have someone else with him? Oh no, because they're force deployed right there, right? Yeah, okay, I was just like, what? I would only have 2/3 of a damn squad. Don't make them stop Cross Omega? It's been going 5 years, so they're probably going to have to relicense a bunch of the stuff that. Yeah, that's right. They started with, like, when they did all the weird licensing thing at the start. Was also licensed from Sega, so it's basically they must have had a 5-year contract with a bunch of stuff and they've earned all their money. Is it also not? Oh no, it's just fucking all sorts of weird bullshit in Cross Omega. But yeah, they have to pay the rights for a bunch of their weird stuff, and then it's 5 years gone, and when it comes time to renew the contracts, it's definitely going to be a case of, oh, Cross Omega was very, very profitable. So we're going to charge you a shit ton of money for our thing now, for the renewal. Drinking. Yeah, he was 5 years old. Which is a long time. Everybody's licensed. Everybody's licensed. It most likely. And they didn't want to go, oh yeah, time to bust out that contract for the Shin-chan robot. Another hero. Hero Breaker at it again. Kids, my name's Engi Gam. I've been a dedicated soldier of Siberian Rail for many years now, so please, do keep me in mind when handing out officer promotions. It's like a little bound dock. Look at him. Subspace beam got a little bit stronger. I think that was 300 before. It looks like all of his moves have got like plus 200 damage from his little upgrade. Oh, Darin Spesa Storm. What do you mean you can't attack at range 2 either? What's your fucking problem? It's range 2 to 6? Oh, he doesn't have oversense level 2. That's why he can't do shit. Never mind. Fucking do this garbage. Goodbye, Gory. Can't even use his own damn platoon attack. We're the clear favourites for a change. Like they say, if you're gonna serve someone, serve the powerful. So please watch, Mr. Kids. Kejinan Dapdol's gonna get the job done. Lord Asham, you're in pursuit of the Black Southern Cross right now, yes? I've got a hunch we'll have an easy win here, so I'm praying for your safety. Sorry, Jabali. That's not happening, is it? Tim will start moving turn three, which hopefully means these bozos will be able to fly over here and beat him up, because I got a sneaking suspicion he's going to be broccoli. Oh, well, winning wouldn't have much of a point if I got injured, so I'm pulling back before anything bad happens. Jaboli Morea. Mariella. Mariella? Mariella? I think she meant to be Jaboli Mariella. Fucking and they're just sitting there going, fuck you, what are you gonna do to me, you fool? Literally insane. So Bruno's got the bit, he's like, this was where I realized Gauli's well, oversense deficiency stopped him from attacking. I spent 15 seconds just staring and thinking, fuck you, Gauli. So Kejanet's like, oh, jeez, I'm out. You're supposed to win, but don't worry. We'll still win. Can't lose. Not with these numbers. I mean, that's certainly a fucking accuracy. I'll eradicate these worms and blossom anew as the chief of operations. Please wait just a bit longer, my train schedule. I'll make you beautiful and perfect again very soon. My diamondo. Diayo. These little onion havers. That'll be better if you want to get his planeta. That was as expected, but it's spicy now, so that's that.
ただのやられ役だと思うなよ。私だって大輔さんの力になる。
grabs that guy's like beer in the air.
Let's
go, Grimlazer. Crush anyone who tries to butt into my match with Gainer. And you think you can entertain me? Let's play together! Cynthia's loving this, just ha 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 ha, this is a blast! And then Gainer's like, what? It's like, Gainer, that voice, it's like, that's Cynthia Lane! It's like, she's in that Overman, Cynthia! And then Bear's like, wait, Gainer's, those, it's like, and then Jin's like, right, yeah, it's Gainer's rival, and, girlfriend, Odessu. She's her rival and girlfriend. And she's like, come on, Gainer, let's have a match. Game start. She's like, quit joking around. This is no game. This is real life. And then Sarah's like, Gainer? We need to, get out of here. We need to run off. She's like, what's wrong, Sarah? Why are you trying to mess up our match? She's like, wait, Cynthia, I don't want to fight you. Hey, why are you saying that? Why? Because I'm your friend? We spoke so many times over the UN and then went out together, didn't we? Yeah, we're friends. We're friends play together. War isn't a game. There are plenty of other ways to have fun besides that. What are you doing, Gainer? This isn't time to chit-chat. But that girl's Gainer's friend. He can't fight her. This ain't a playground. You gotta kill anyone who stands against you, even friends. I won't. Holland. Gainer, if you're that certain, then you must do something about this. Harin, you think of a way to deal with her if you don't want to feel the same regret I did. Make the first move, and we'll back you up. Duh. How stupid can these guys be? Don't they get what kind of mess we're in? You joking, Holland? You're the most reckless guy around here, so shut up. For a caution of the wind, Gainer. Just get in there and give it 110%. That's what being a kid's all about. You help him, Sarah. Man, hello, everyone. Let's go, Gainer. Susie doesn't understand what battle's really like. Just have to teach, then. You playing for keeps now, Gainer? Let's have some fun together, then. Come on, then, Cynthia. I'll show you the battles aren't games at all. It's Super Bowl's getting the entire G Gundam tournament? Now that's what you want. Every SR point is free. Because every SR point is, no one's got to beat the fucker up. I'm kicking this guy's shit in. Sorry, Kashmir, you gotta go. Get fucking double punched, clown. Let's go, Apollo. And then they're like, punch the fuck out of you. Pointless to stand against my planet. Bishimashi. Schedule is diamond. It's perfect. Let me punch him a second time, and he's even less happy about that. So Kashmir's not happy squandering the chance that Kids gave him, and his return to his former position has just been postponed. Hence that he's a scheduled other man. But hopefully this has been enough. Games up here. Come on, Gainer. We're gaming. Let's make this a good one, Gainer. Time for an actual Overman battle. This is for real. She acts like it's a game, but she's shooting to kill. Can't she tell the difference between the sim and an actual fight? Is that why she can murder others so easily? She thinks it's a damn game. Cooking. Too bad for y'all, folks. There are some folks in this here world that you really shouldn't piss off. That goes double for the rich. They're a vindictive bunch and got power and time to make good on it. That's how it is, you know? Better keep that in mind after I get my fresh start, too. But goddamn, howdy, y'all! I'm gonna let you fuckers do what you want. Already done. Let's do it. Let's get wild. Yep, that's Tim. That's Tim. Yeah, that's right. It's fucking good, actually. Soul's burning. Yeah, he's beating up the land ship. He's done with him. He should get the hop here. Actually, he might not, because Timp is strong as fuck. Giant Jarenchi. Death Crunch. Busted through. And then the robot's crying! The two finest thing in this world. When a robot purges its armor to reveal its true power, and when the robot cries. Damn. That's the good stuff. So Tim's just like, you know what? Just can't get in the mood to fight for real if old Melonhead's not around. But, either way, victory should be as good as theirs now, so he's just gonna sit back and watch the show. He's not even gonna get in the broccoli? Oh, what's the fucking point of being alive? I was ready for the broccoli. But no broccoli for me. This is the worst. I feel as disappointed as Tim does that Melonhead's not around. Jump on this guy. There's something in our life that would be good.
どう愛なりますやなった。いけ、アイアンギア。いけ、アイアンギア。ゴ、アイアンギア。飛べ。アイアンギア。フライ。
It's an anime, ain't it? Bonk. Shoot that guy, fucking dead. No trace of him left, squashed completely flat. And so, now that's all of the bad guys except the Dominator. Which means it's time to switch the fleet. Double Harken. Bam, bam, bam. Razor. Marin Kata. I don't think you should be calling Marin, to be honest.
Shoulder.
Fight me. Song. It's a duel. Double Haken. Double Haken. Such a good, like, resetting animation, just turned into a little swirly ball. The Dominator's overskill. Thinking about these stiff animations here. On the Dominator.
Shikoncho.
Drinking. And only regular Pulsar, but... Fucking simply just like, oh fuck. What the? Yep. Shine Spark strong. Three hearts is one. It's the power that's a million. She's that open. I'm slow? I lost. They pushed me this far? She's just like, oh, this is amazing, alright. Time for round two then. And fully healed. It's like, this girl, what the? And she tells Kizuna to watch, because she's going to win this time. And Odette's like, oh no, this kid, this is Kizuna's famous treasure child. And he's like, wait, fight's on his orders? Oh jeez. And then Genda's like, alright, time to charge inside this crystal and deal with this fucker. So they go inside the big egg. And Sirius says that attempting to destroy the fortress from inside is a rather foolhardy plan. But Cynthia runs in after him, because she's not going to let anyone lay a finger on kids. Kids munts. And considering that we're in deep, everyone agrees to just, like, sit here and keep anyone else from following Gaynor inside. And Matthew's tired as hell, but Apollo's eager to keep going. And that's the hypno sound. And so here's Hayato, like, this is real bad timing. And Rim's like, are they trying to finish us off? Taking advantage of our pinchy? And then Rina's like, no, that's not it. I sense that the fallen angels are after a different enemy. And then Tifa says, the frigid devil is awakening. And so they go inside in this weird... so they're inside the Agate Crystal, and Gaynor and Sarah are like, this is weird. Like, we're nowhere near Siberia, but it's completely frozen? Outside's nice and warm, that's weird. And then... big roar. And that is not... it's like, is that the hypno sound? The guy's like, no, that is not the hypno sound. It's a different voice, one that feels like it could freeze your heart just by listening to it. And Sarah's like, wait, Gaynor, that block of ice! Shh. Is it by the T-Rex? No. It's the Bungus. So here's Martina. She comes out of the block of ice because she heard the Song of Ice. Listen to it. And she says this... Who's foolish enough to stir the Overdevil once more? Gaynor and Sarah have no idea what's going on. And then Cynthia comes over and she's like, hey, come back outside and finish our game, Gaynor. He's like, hey, us fighting and the game is two different things. She's like, I don't really get it. Like, fighting with an Overman is fun, whether it's in the video game or real life. Nothing gets her blood pumping like a good match. And then her late mother and her other mother were both great Overman pilots. And she says that explains why she has so much fun. And then the roar. And Gaynor tells Sarah they need to get out of here fast. And she's just, ah, yay, getting serious now. Is it Cynthia? And she's like, yeah, it's no fun playing with you unless you're serious. And then, Gaynor, you two okay? Everybody run, it's dangerous to stay here. Either of you say, kid, there's lots of angels in the way. What's that voice? Came from the Agate Crystal. Found you, Gaynor. Wait, what's that light? Something happening between that Overman and King Gaynor? Oh, I was right. The dreadlocked Overman is the Overdevil's kin. The Dominator's overskill got a power-up, too. That's gonna make for an even better match. Enough! I'm sick of getting pushed around by some power I don't even understand. Think fast, Gaynor. My body's frozen. Gaynor? I win! I beat the champ! See that, Sarah? I'm the best in battles with real Overmen. But you're really good too, Gaynor. With a bit more practice, you... Ugh. Gaynor, you're hurt. Huh? You're bleeding way too much. We need to stop this right now, or... Cynthia, you did this. You hurt Gaynor. My fault? Yeah, it's your fault. I didn't think this would happen, I swear! I was just happy that I could fight Gaynor with real Overmen. It was just for fun. and then stop acting like a kid. Think about it for a second. Unlike your games, there are real people piloting these overmen. Zara, grab King Gain and bring it over. We gotta get out of here. All units retreat. Break through the enemy's lines. The voice is getting louder. Something's happening inside the fortress. It's coming. Look at it. What is that? Another overman? Frigid devil. Look at him. Look at him. He's a little weird, three-eyed bat pig. Oh, I hate the over devil so much. Oh, he really fucks me off. A devil overman? An over devil? Bat pig, nemesis to spider pig. Absolutely. So, the fallen angels are going after it? Animosity. They fear that creature's awakening. Destroyed the cherubim in one blow? It's even more monstrous than it appears. Magnificent. It wiped out its ancient nemesis with such ease. If I could control this power, the whole world would bow to my will. That's the Overdevil. King Gainers. Ah, there you are, Roger. That monster. It's an ancient early Overman. That is the legacy of the Black History. Angel said the truth lay with it, but... we'll cover you guys. Get out of there! Retreat, quickly! Yes, flee. Now that the Overdevil's been revived, there are none who can stand in my way. I think they now realize just how terrifying the Siberian Rail and I truly are. Sorry, I'm so sorry, Gainer. I never wanted to hurt you, but... I'm sorry, Gainer. Sorry, Sarah. Poor Cynthia. She's just... weird. So I bought the Freedon. Garrod tells everybody that they've decided to leave Renton alone until he's found his own answers, and Tex is like, "Ooh, yeah, that's good." He was worried that the only reason that Renton left was because he fucking hated Holland, but it seems like Renton's got a lot more going on than just that. So Tifa's looking forward to Renton and Eureka changing for the better, because neither of them can remain children forever. Ren notices that instead of Renton, Gareth brought a new girl along and let his Paula with a fucking spherical fucking head like a fucking orange. So it's Paula. He's like, "Howdy everybody, it's me." And so here you go. Yeah, it's fucking just, there's no ears on. Yeah, like she looks like she's wearing one of them anime girl masks, but that's just her face. Yeah, she looks totally different from every other... She's a Gundam X lady. She's a Gundam X lady, and she just looks nothing like anybody else in Gundam X at all. It's really weird. But she introduces, and we'll get a full introduction when we do the other path, but it's like, oh yeah, she's here. She was with the Argama. Hanging out with them, and she's here to hang out. The way she's a Gundam X lady. And, yeah, and she's bought the G-Falcon, which is a Gundam-type support mecha. Yeah, and, yep, yeah, so with the G-Falcon and the DX, they can combine, and it charges increases how fast the satellite cannon charges. We'll get to that. And Tonya's glad that Neil's joining, having finally got tired of clinging to her pride and determined to live honestly to herself from now on. Rand and Roybu would never turn away another two girls, but they definitely chose a bad time to arrive. And Jimmy was like, "Oh yeah, that Overdevil is way beyond what we can deal with, holy shit." And the way he blew up all those fallen angels is proof of that. But why were they even fighting each other in the first place? Maybe they just don't like each other? And Wits is like, ah, well, good, let them wreck each other. Fine by me. As Vagina Tex says that while he did lose a lot of blood, he's not in danger, and Sarah's keeping watch over him right now. Holland steps over, and Garrett's like, if you are here to fucking gloat about Renton not coming back yet, just like you wanted, I'm gonna be... And he's like, hey, no, Gain already told me why you're here, kid. That's not why I'm here. Damn, Brett. What he wants to ask is about the mercenary couple that Garrett's group met. Ray and Charles, right? He goes, Charles and Ray, yeah? And Garrett's like, oh, I was not expecting that question. Husband-wife combo that beat me up. Beat me up like a tanuki and a kitsune. Like a raccoon and a fox. Holy shit. And Holland's like, yep, that's what I thought. All right. And so he tells Jamil that the Gecko State are going off on their own. And Wits is like, oh, leave the rest of us behind as bait, huh? And he's like, nope, got to settle the score in our own way. And he says, if Garrod really met the Charles and Ray that he knows, they'll be coming sooner or later. And as his and Eureka's enemies. And Jamil can tell from the look in Holland's eyes that he's gained some measure of introspection. And Holland's like, oh, is that your new type powers? And he's like, mm-hmm. Sure, alright. And he says, you've seen both the alien and the gamer put their lives on the line for what they believe in. Completely unconcerned with failure. And he's going to do better than a gamer. So he's not going to run away. And Jamil's not going to press him for details. So he just tells Holland to go handle his business and not worry about the team here. And then Rand's like, yeah, you better whoop some serious butt now that you finally got your game face on, bud. And then Holland sort of smiles and tells the repairman this is the sort of time when he never misses. And he assures Rand that when he gets back, he'll buy him a drink in exchange, ask that Rand puts up with listening to him yammer on. Damn, I can't believe all it took for Holland to stop being a shit was to be worried that everyone was going to die. Damn. And also everybody telling him to stop being a shit and they weren't going to talk to him anymore. And so, Gaino wakes up. He's well enough to see some guests. Jiren tells him not to worry about the Siberian Rail business and just recover. And then Mel tells Sarah to call us if there's anything they need. And she says, nah, it'll be fine. Medic taught her how to tend to the bandages. So, Adet shoos everybody out to leave Gaino be. And then Rogan's like, ah. Gaino's heart has far greater wounds than those on his body. Benkei's like, oh yeah, that makes sense. He was hurt by a friend who seems to have got quite a shock herself. So Sarah asks Gain if she wants to eat something before taking a nap. And he's just... thinking about the month before the Exodus, the month when his parents were killed, and he never left his room. And that was when Cynthia befriended him over the internet, and he decided it's his turn as her friend to help her in the same way, and he wants to show her what's right and what's wrong. And so Sarah just says that Cynthia must be very much like Gaina, used to be. He's like, damn, used to be a gamer like that, Gaina? Damn. And she guesses that Cynthia must be very, very lonely, and she knows how that feels quite well herself. And so she wants to be with Gaina when they meet her again. And the Gaina is like, yeah. But for that to work, though, she tells Gaina to concentrate on healing himself and bids him goodnight. And then as she leaves, yeah, she's like, see ya, good night. And then Gaina's thinking about his and Cynthia's Overman's response to the Overdevil. And he knows he's got to get much stronger to help her. The stronger than she is, stronger than Gain, stronger than the Overdevil, and even stronger than the King Gainer itself. And so, well, we found the devil everyone's been talking about, and it fucking sucked shit. And this is still part of the root split, but everybody's all back together.